Nanjo. You did another.
To record it.
Senator Oluremi, born 21st September 1960, is the former First Lady and currently a Senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, representing Lagos Central Senatorial District. She is a member of the All Progressive Congress, APC. Oluremi Tinubu was the youngest of 12 children. She was raised in Ogun State. Tinubu received a BSc in Education from the University of Ife and the National Certificate of Education in Botany and Zoology from the Adeyemi College of Education. Oluremi Tinubu became the First Lady of Lagos State when her husband, Bola Ahmed Tinubu, was elected as governor of the state.
She's the mother of Lagos, mother of modern day Lagos. Recall that she started the program, New Era Program. Started it, spreading B, she started during her time, and up to today, she's still sustaining the program, despite the fact that she's no longer in novice as the wife of the governor. And recall also too that she's a sitting senator, and when it comes to taking care of Lagos, she sees the role of Lagos as her constituency.
She has been saddled with many responsibilities as a senator, and she has proven her worth among the women folk that make up the center in this present Senate. And it's a role model to us, because she has proven to us that if given a woman a chance, Nigerian can be proud of it. She has described herself among her colleagues as a case study in Lagos State here, holding a regular town hall meeting as well as poverty alleviation, giving to the teeming population of her immediate constituency by way of empowering them and reducing the level of poverty within our constituency.
Don't forget that we're talking of a woman who says a woman can do everything and anything. She could have been contented with, you know, all the loads on her as a wife of a national leader, a man that everybody just holds on to, you know, a man that everybody believes in. But she took another bold step to contest the elections into the Senate. And you could see that she didn't take anything for granted. She worked very hard as a senator to make a difference, and she did make a difference. She's one of the very, one of those parliamentarians that had constant town hall meetings, reaching out to people regularly. She didn't say, well, I'm Mrs. Tinubu, so what? She did the work very well. She made a difference. She made an impact. That is the Mrs. Tinubu that we're celebrating today.
She's somebody that is worthy of admiration. As a woman, I am very, very proud of her. She's pride to the women fold in the way she discharges her duty as a mother, as a wife, as a public officer. She has been my role model for a very long time. I'm not the type that shouts or talk too much about people. I may be silent about so many things, but she's somebody that I admire so much. I admire her so much, and I learn a lot from her. She's our defender. She protects women. She's our role model. She's somebody that we are very, very proud of, and every woman in every opportunity that we have as a woman, she should stand up for herself. That is what she has been doing. She knows her onions. And she's really, really doing well.
She's a very special woman. She's the mother of our dynasty.
You know, they see other people and they are tall, they are moving.
She is the pillar of our leader, dynasty. And she has played that role for a very long time. To the extent that, when you look back at where we are coming from, we really appreciate her. I always tell my wife that she should always try to copy her. That if a woman can stand her ground,
oh, you will get everything. That way we will go look for carpenter. When you take their hand,
she has evolved
to
the voice in Nigeria. She full of this feminist personality. To the extent that she stands up for women every time.
She's a mother. A leader, a self-giver, a philanthropic, a grassroots mobilizer, and a crusader, just name it, a wayfarer. So when he now eventually joined politics, became a senator, the way she's behaving, even in plenary, in that constituency, in that place, where she live with people, and the welfare programs she put up, her sister is second. She listened to all our sundry, and we attend to you according to your plight, according to your problems. That's why I call her a mother, a prophet, a crusader, a fairies, just a good housewife.
Mama is to those of us who we can describe as our mother, or as our political leader, or political mentor, is always willing to associate with us. He's running a sort of open door policy. That is, whenever we run to her, he's ready to assist us, he's ready to listen to us. And as a mother, as a politician, is perfectly fitting into those sectors.
Chief Mrs. Irongo is, to me, is my teacher. She's my friend. She's my big sister. She's my mentor. She's a woman of many parts. She relates to people according to who they are. And when we were working together in Lagos, when she was first lady of Lagos State, wife of the governor, I was commissioner for women and girls, so we worked together to better the lot of women, children, and men's middle age. And she's someone that won the best from everybody.
Distinguished Senator for the Republic of Nigeria, Senator Oluremi Tinubu, can be described as the mother of the nation. And to us within this district, she's a mother to all. Very, very eloquent leader. A careful person.
Little people do grow.
And a very modest person.
I like his family name.
Life. And things to do, and also she can speak out as a disciplinarian that she does. I want to congratulate her for being 60.
Senator Oluremi Tinubu, she's a role model. She's a mother. She's somebody that I cannot compare with somebody. I want to say she's somebody that one could emulate in life. You know why? She's a godly minded woman being. She's a loving and caring mother. She's everything that I believe every woman that's reasonable has.
Senator Oluremi Tinubu, she's a mother. She's a giver. She's a giver. And she's someone that have done a lot for us. Central Central District, where she's representing and the state as a whole. And someone that cares.
He 14 children.
He's not so difficult.
I said I'm looking for him.
Put it down for them.
This month she feels familiar.
He's the one that they made commissioner that gave me 20,000.
That's sweet.
No, he was giving me from this thing.
How much are you?
He has told me that he did anything. You understand?
He's rude to me. You say it's ginger.
Not still, but you know, they bring out in the night.
There are some people that they are nothing. They will tell you they can name them. Several occasions, during our swearing in at Abuja, 2015, and this 2019. You see her kneeling down for our leaders. With our two knees on the floor. With our two knees on the floor. With what she has, a third time.
And there's one being messed up. She said this to them.
A wife of a leadership of a party, a national leadership, a national.
How are you to come?
Oh, a worldwide Jacobin wife. That's a woman. No, no, no. She's just too old. There was a time they were doing this Muse Anidu sports when Chief Larry Azak Okoya came.
It has been a very good politician. Very good politician. At the National Assembly, you can see her performance.
Okay,
her performance speaks volume. It speaks volume. And it has been up and doing. And in fact, the third time like that is running now, it's more or less. The people at that senatorial, we appeal to her, you know, to go for the daughter. Not that she willingly asked for
she
it.
She just tell your friend that she's okay.
Because someone that performed creditably well, and someone that people really love, and is, you know, attending to people, irrespective of your status or whatever. You see, someone like me, as I've said, I've involved in a program of a new era program, the Spelling Bee, the Music Fiesta, that is usually common in December, the Caring for the Aged, that's also common where you assembled 100 aged in 13 local governments, in all the 13 local governments that consist in the senatorial district every year. And that is 1,300.
Convener of the annual Musical Youth Fiesta Initiative to promote godly lifestyle among the youths. Yeah. Senator Oluremi Tinubu also co-sponsored the Muniru Muse Under 15 football competition for boys and girls. She has written a number of publications, including an autobiography, The Journey of Grace, My Faith Work, and delivered informed presentations at various fora at home and abroad. Endowment funds in four universities. School building constructed at the Oluremi Tinubu Elementary and Junior High School, Johnsonville, Montserrado County, Liberia. Science block for Adeyemi College of Education, Ondo. Considerable donations towards the building of the National Sickle Cell Center. Donation of her entire 50th birthday monetary gift to social causes, school scholarship scheme. Annual disbursement of 100,000 to 26 beneficiaries for 4 years, and 624 students of tertiary institutions received 10,000 as book bursaries. Grants to help 650 beneficiaries within her constituency to recapitalize their businesses. Provision of maintenance grants to alleviate the plight of the elderly citizen assistance scheme. Sponsorship of youth empowerment and skill acquisition scheme to enable more youths in her constituency to become economically productive and self-employed. Helped secure 377 million funding from the Tertiary Education Trust Fund for three institutions: Sir Michael Otedola College of Primary Education, Lagos State University, and Adeniran Ogunseya College of Education. Through the Senate Committee on Education, she obtained federal support for the rehabilitation of Jibowu Junior High School, Yaba, Banjo Primary School, Otumara, Idubu, Ebute Meta, as well as 15 million each for Holy Trinity Primary School, Ebuteru, and Sarudin Primary School, Okekobo, and Iriakare Primary School, Orilegbemi. As First Lady, she established the New Era Foundation, dedicated to stabilizing centers for all-round development of young ones and promote public awareness on environmental health and community service. When Remi Tinubu was elected, it was challenged at the Legislative House Election Petition Tribunal, which later convened and upheld the election in 2012. Tinubu was one of over 100 senators elected in the 8th Assembly in 2015. However, only 6 of these were women. Senator Oluremi Folasade Tinubu is married to former governor and senator of Lagos State, Senator Bola Ahmed Tinubu. He is a Christian, a mother, a mentor, and a role model to our generation, a priceless gift of nature.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you, mommy. Happy birthday to you. I want to wish her long life and prosperity, in good health, with God protection and guidance, and also that to witness more of fruitful years ahead of her life.
I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to do it. I'm not pray that God will continue to be with you. God will continue to be with you. Whatever you lay your hands on, will prosper. God will prosper you. God will stand by you. God will be there for you.
I want to congratulate Mama for the milestone to attain a 60 years old. I want to pray for her that God will give her the good health, he will give her long life, he will continue to flourish at 70, at 80, at 90, and so on and so forth. He will continue to be prosper, he will continue to be flourish. And whatever be her heart desire, I pray that God Almighty will grant it for her.
She's a very special woman. I give thanks and admiration to God for the type of life he has given to her. She has been living a very healthy life, and I pray that she should continue to live in health, in wealth, and in progress. Sky is the beginning for her because she has proven that she can be on her own. She can do so many things that men cannot do.
My prayer for her is to live long and enjoy her, the fruit of her hard earned labor. My prayer for her is to continue to live as long as she is herself. I want to wish her happy birthday, long life and prosperity, many years and grateful, glorious, fruitful years ahead.
Ola joy be, ijo koe o, she were, oda wa. Mama temi o, happy birthday. Mama tiwa o, happy birthday. Senator Rebi Balibe Tulumbu, long life, in good health, joy, happiness.
Odupe tori ori anugba re mi. Odupe ori anugba o. Tori ki se gbogbo eniyan lori anugba. Always thank God. And I thank God for you. And I continue to thank God for you. God bless you. God bless your children. God bless your husband. Whatever your desire in future, God Almighty, make it to be a reality by God's grace.
Mama wa, Senator, the Congress Senator, Oluremi Tinubu, me to daruko wa. Mama wa, ara ni ale, ela la fia, epe fuwa o. Mama wa, ara ni ale, ela la fia. May the good Lord bless you. May the good Lord bless you. In Jesus' name I pray. May the good Lord bless you.
Ah, dear Yeye Tinubu, happy birthday today. May God's blessings be with your ways. May your wishes all come true. May you have a strong foundation when the weather's shift is shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. And may you stay. May you stay forever young.
Mm-hmm.
I don't start again. Hello, you